Hi everyone, Alfred here from Alfred.tv with a quick and dirty unboxing. Quick and dirty, like one of my Discord moderator's underwear. Can you figure out who it is? Let's do the unboxing. So I got the popcorn, I got the maple syrup, and I got what I thought was a kettle corn making machine, but nay, nay, I really screwed up on this one. This thing isn't a kettle corn making machine. Kettlebell, kettle corn. All right. Hey, it was on sale. What the hell? So I'm going to open up this thing. It's actually part of the BowFlex, you know, adjustable weights. Nice. And what's the main driver for unboxing that now? Is because I need to use the dolly. And what do you say when you see a dolly?
Hello, dolly. Yes, this synthesizes the middle of the freaking living room because I'm still doing painting and upgrades to beachside. It'll get done hopefully by the end of the year.
So there it is, the official Shiv, used for many unboxings and also for helping with, like, you know, Christmas gift wrapping, because you gotta cut the, you know, industrial duct tape. Okay, so obviously it comes with a manual, and yeah, there indeed is not the kettle corn making machine, but indeed the kettlebell. Okay, so there are the components. It comes with a plastic base so you don't scratch the hell out of your freaking tile floor. And there indeed is the non-kettle corn making machine. Obviously, it defaults to 40 pounds, and I pretty much hurt my back lifting it out. I should have dialed it down. And yeah, I guess you just, you know, it's probably going to be in the base to do the dialing. I'm going to assume there's some type of a safety lock. So let me put it in the base. Boom, 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 boom. Yeah, I made a bass joke. Yes, I was indeed correct. Once it's in the bass, it lets you dial up a weight. So let's quickly document the various weight excrements. I mean increments. So we have 8 pounds. And then it looks like we go to 12, 20, 25. What's this one? Is it 30? Oh, damn. 35. Should have been 34. And then max out at 40. Nice. Overall construction, actually, it's very good. And it's pretty cool how the whole gear system works, how you hit the dial and it pulls up the amount of weights that you dialed up. I'm a big fan of this stuff. Well, if I was a fan, it'd be like spinning from the ceiling.
And by the way, I did confirm that there are rubber pads on the base. And once you remove at the desired weight, there are still rubber pads at the bottom of the kettlebell itself, so as not to scratch up your beautiful tile, if you have beautiful tile, unlike me that still has a workout mat in his living room.
And to help me optimize my use of the kettlebell, I got these handy dandy kettlebell exorcise, yes, I said exorcise, cards, like I said, to give me some guidance on what to do with the freaking thing, though I'm sure the manual has some workout options in it as well. And regarding the manual having workout instructions, I was absolutely wrong. There are indeed multiple manuals in different languages for you know, localization purposes. I think the last one was like written in Sanskrit or whatever.
And that kettlebell I did get on sale on Amazon.com. It was like $120. A normal list price is $200.
And speaking seriously for a very brief moment, the kettlebell from BowFlex will augment these selectable, adjustable dumbbells I also got from BowFlex with this lovely stand. And quite honestly, it was just on display for like 2 years to look nice in my living room. And then COVID hit, so I've been working out at home with these. And they're really very, very good. Good product.
So there it is. A quick and dirty unboxing of the BowFlex SlectTech. What the hell's the model number? Let's see. 840 adjustable kettlebell. It does not make kettle corn. Dang it. More to come. Stay tuned. Terrible video.
Look at this Alfred.tv cinematography. I will say that the BowFlex kettlebell sits real nice and pretty under that stand. I mean, really, it just makes like a lovely conversation piece.
Welcome to Alfred.TV.